Arts. We're doing a protest in harmony for Anthony McClain. And if you want to just go ahead and go on your social media, we're a little bit, you know, this is a protest, so everything is in divine time. So let your folks know that they can come. It's a musical tribute. We're going to be featuring R&B and hip hop from locals. Again, my name is Faye Love.
Just what I've been going through. My nights are so long as I watch each hour go by, hoping and praying that someday I will be your guy.
Hi, this is Alan Shea with Art Society Show, and I'm here with Linda, and she is part of Shepherd's Door here in Pasadena, a great nonprofit organization right here in our own backyard. So why don't you give us a little history about your organization and let us know what you're doing here today.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Linda O'Frey, and I'm the Executive Director for Shepherd's Door Domestic Violence Resource and Education Center here in Pasadena. I'm very proud to say we are celebrating 21 years of anniversary this month. We work with victims and survivors of domestic violence, as well as perpetrators of domestic violence. So we're very happy to be in the community. We are here at Holy Assembly Church with the Peace Walk with My Tribe Rise. And they're celebrating Anthony McClain as well as Fee Love. So it's just great to be out here. It's great to be among my peers and my colleagues, and I'm very happy to see everyone.
Well, Linda, why don't we look at that camera and let our viewers know the pride of Pasadena. As you know, it's really been a difficult period over the last year with COVID-19 and certainly with all the civil unrest we've had. What would you share with the viewers that has been a great uptick that we've had here in Pasadena as a result of our community?
Well, what I would say, and I would encourage everyone, because of COVID, we have all kind of been separated and disconnected, but I want everyone in Pasadena to be encouraged. I want us all to come together. I want us all to know that we are all important, that we all need one another, and that together here in Pasadena, we can make a difference, we can make changes. But we all have to come together. We have to come together on one accord. And so I think for Pasadena, we need to all continue to support one another, show love, understanding, and caring for one another.
And last but not least, before we let you go, why don't you share with the viewers really the impact that Shepherd's Door has had since you guys established it, and let the viewers know how long you've been around.
Well, once again, I'm proud to say Shepherd's Door, this year we've been around 21 years. And so we've made major impact here in Shepherd's Door. Last year in 2020, we impact over 1,900 people, 1,900 individuals, and we impact them in many different ways. Many of these individuals were impacted through domestic violence, whether it be food giveaways, whether it be our group sessions, whether it was our individual counseling. We have been doing major work in the city of Pasadena for a very long time. And so we are very proud. With COVID-19, we have seen an increase, so it's been extremely stressful this last 2020 going into 2021. But nevertheless, we are here. We're passionate about what we do. We're making life changing every day. And so we're going to continue to do what we do because we love what we do.
We want to thank you so much because we love that Pasadena community pride that we got here in Pasadena. So I want to thank you. And viewers, stay around because we're going to have some great entertainment coming up here at the community rally we got going here. So stay with us.
Grandma's hands clapped in church on Sunday morning. Grandma's hands played the tuba breeze so well. Grandma's hands used to issue out a warning. She said, Toya, don't you run so fast. I'd fall on a piece of glass. I'd be sneezing in that glass. Grandma's hands. Hey, love.
right, so see here. So I'll control the mic. You always look at the camera. Okay. And I'll stand about here because if I want to edit it, okay. So right on you then. I always look there.
Okay.
We're here today with Nicole, and she's going to share with us, what does this day mean, this week mean, and certainly the community here and celebrating Anthony and Faye Love and how the community has just come together.
This day and week, I mean, it means everything. You know, I know that, you know, we all need to, you know, come together, and we need peace. You know, we just need, you know, justice for Anthony, for everyone. So I'm glad. This is just a beautiful day. I really enjoyed it.
So what would you share with the viewers about the progress that's been made by the community and the impact it's had on the family?
Well, as far as today, I just see that there's black, there's white, Asians, everyone's coming together. You know, to me, all lives matter, and it's just, I'm just so happy to see everybody here together today, you know, coming as one. And, you know, we all represent the same thing, peace.
And last but not least, before I let you go, how has the McClain family really engaged their new family as a community at large? Because now your family has grown 15 times as large with everybody that you've come to know, and you know, that's certainly been a part of the family since you know, we lost Anthony.
Wow, I mean, our family, we are just so, you know, overwhelmed. I mean, enlightened with all the much love and support. Like you said, we're all family. I mean, we just love everybody and just thank everyone since day one for your love and support. It's been really hard, and I mean, you guys have been there and supported us, and you continue, you know, to support our family, and we appreciate it so much.
Well, we want to thank you, and in memory of Mimi, you know, she was special to me. I was glad to get a chance to really get to know her and be one of her sons, and really get a good understanding of what she wanted, and hopefully, you know, we'll carry that forward, moving forward in the future, so that will become part of this community, is, you know, what she touched us with.
Yes, I appreciate it. Yes, and I mean, I know she's looking down. I know that she's not here physically, but I know she's here spiritually looking down, and she would be very proud of today for all this love and support. And again, you know, we appreciate you guys for everything. Like you said, we are all family.
With that being said, I want to thank you, my dear.
You're welcome.
All right. All
thank
right.
You.
Thank you.
Sometimes in our lives,
everybody,
we all have pain.
Yeah.
We all have sorrow. If we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow.
Lean on me.
Lean on me.
We are not strong.
Not strong.
I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on. For it won't be long. I'm gonna need somebody to.
Why don't you introduce yourself to the viewers, look at the camera here, and then share with them how's today's event going.
I'm Sylvia Holmes, and today is wonderful. I'm glad to celebrate Faye Love's life, and I felt very lucky to have met her and worked with her. She was interested in the climate. I happen to be holding a book about the climate. And I want to continue the effort of her hashtag, When Black and Brown Go Green.
So why don't you share with the viewers your time commitment that you've had with Faye since we're celebrating her today, and then how that morphed into your connection with Anthony McClain.
Oh yeah, that's right. So the first thing that Faye and I did together was the Black History Parade. And it was Octavia Butler themed. And then the next thing we were doing was murals, and then Black Lives Matter. And then the next thing you know, Anthony McClain was murdered by the police. And so we had a protest in harmony with the music at Memorial Park. And I helped with that.
And that was awesome. I really enjoyed that concert, considering what we were up against. Because we were up against a couple of things, including losing the daylight.
That's right. We didn't have any lights. It got dark. That's right. That was funny.
Right. It was funny. But we worked our way through. We had some creative things that happened with people, you know, supporting us with their lighting equipment, so that worked out well. So what do you think the outcome will be for today as far as the turnout once the group comes back from the walk?
I think the music is going to be similar to the concert aspect of the protest in harmony, and people will have a wonderful time here with the music.
And so since you've been a part of Compassion, so what do you see the possible long-term projection now that we have to really figure out how to come together as a result of losing Faye to keep her vision and her passion of it moving forward?
You know, she was working on so many projects that I personally could never have juggled that many. So I'm going to help out with the ones that interest me the most. And I hope that other people will step forward and help out with the ones that interest them.
Well, I think that's the only way we can do it at this moment until we find someone who can fit that same commitment that Faye had, because she was really an amazing woman. And, you know, I had a great opportunity to spend quality time with her father before he left. And I can see where she gets all of her, her passion and, you know, really people skills.
Right. He was a very generous man in the position that he was when we should be caring for him about losing his daughter. And he was so generous and wanted to care for all of us. Wow.
Well, I want to thank you, Sylvia. You, ever since I've met you, you've been a sweetheart and certainly been a person who's been committed to seeing this vision grow. So I thank you. And I'm sure the viewers are glad to see how we are all coming together to make sure this live on.
Thank you.
Alan. Thank you. Thank you.
I was born by the river.
Come on now.
In a little tent. Just like the river I've been running ever since. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come.
Yes.
Oh, yes it will. I can go to the movies, I can go downtown. Somebody tell me, Lord, hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, we. Oh, Lord. Then I go to my brother, yeah. And I say, brother, help me please. Then he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there were times when I thought I couldn't last for long. But now I know I'm able to carry on. It's been a long, y'all say, long time coming. It's been a long
time coming.
Oh, it's been a long
time coming.
Oh, it's been a long
time coming.
Change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will.
Thank you. Yeah. Love you, Faith.
Hi, I'm here with one of the founders
of Compassionate California. I'm a chief compassionate officer with Faye Love and Kara and Joanne, who's also here, and some other folks that aren't here. But it's a blessing to be here in Pasadena because this was Faye's home, love, on the ground place to bring her art and action together. It's great to be here with the community that she loved, with her people from all over the place, together with Dina United, which is one of the hip things that Faye did all the time to bring people into the work, into the love, into the art, and just honored and blessed to be here.
So what would you share about the energy that came through today and the support from the community?
It's incredible, actually. Right now you can hear four-way harmony singing right now, and Faye would be like asking folks to get up off their feet and sing and dance, and the march and the action is beautiful, and the neighbors are all waving and connecting with folks, and for Anthony McClain and his family was here, and Mario's family, and all of us are a family. So that's really what Faye brought here.
Absolutely. So why don't you share with the viewers, look in that camera, and share with them what would you like to see come of Faye's vision and certainly compassion art here in Pasadena.
Faye was about bringing people to community together and using art and love and expression to bring justice to folks that are underserved and for folks to be held accountable for their actions around racism and inequity. And so what I'd love to see is for justice for the family and the life of Anthony McClain and all the other black folks who've been slain in the streets or in their homes or everywhere, and for us to all be knowing that we're all connected together and that this is all of our work together, and that's what we're here for.
Wow, well, that's very poetic. It hits it right on the head, what we need to know. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for your work, Alan, because I know you're out here carrying on her legacy almost like nobody else. I just got chills, you know. Really, thank you.
Well, she brought us all together, so we just have to keep her vision going.
Yes, and thank you. And her, that's it.
Thank you.